closing in the House tomorrow should still be able to do that. Mike Calhoun is the president of the Center for Responsible Lending.
In the short run, within the next few days this week, it is likely not to happen.
There's like your bones.
But the FHA is operating with a skeleton crew of just 5% of its normal staff. So if the shutdown drags on longer,
good boy, Joey,
could quickly get back up and home sales could start to fall through. Chris Arnold, NPR News.
Somewhat rocky first day for the opening of the Affordable Care Act health insurance exchanges. NPR's Julie Rodman reports many officials are blaming technical glitches on higher than expected.
Good girl, Daisy.
More than 2.8 million people had visited the Federal Exchange website by mid-afternoon.
You like your bone?
It quickly became inaccessible.
You like your bone?
Current users to access various state sites. Still, despite technical problems of their own, states like Colorado, California, Illinois, and Kentucky all reported tens of thousands of visitors in the first hours. And for those who persevered, thousands managed to create accounts they can use to buy insurance. Most people had to bring their patients, though, as websites crashed, call centers backed up, and technical experts promised to try to get things on track as fast as they can. Julie Rodner, NPR News.
Home prices are continuing their rebound, fueled by more buyers competing for limited stockpile of houses on the market.
You need thumbs.
Rising mortgage interest rates. Real estate data provided for Logic nationwide, home prices were up more than 12% in August. On Wall Street today, the Dow Jones Industrial Bank is gaining 62 points, plus 15,191. The NASDAQ rose 46 points. You're listening to NPR News in Washington. On WAT News in Atlanta.
How do you guys like your bones? What do you think, Joey? You like it? Is that good?
Due to excessive drought during the 2012-2013 winter season, the Robinson blamed Florida's problems on overfishing and natural conditions.
In the past, when there have been low water flows, it's not because Metro Atlanta was using it; it's because there was a drought. Nobody had water.
Oh, did you like that?
Florida ignored efforts by Beal last year to strike a broader deal with Georgia and Alabama over water use, and in 2011.
Daisy, you're silly.
The Supreme Court ordered declined to review the case, handing Georgia a big win in the interstate feud. Calls to Florida's governor's office were not immediately returned. Michelle Malloy, WABE News.
Support for NPR comes from NPR member stations and from Joyce V. Hale, seeking a world challenged and invigorated to a deeper understanding of ideas. Now a mixture of clouds and sun, 79 degrees. Support for WABE comes from Coles College of Business at Kennesaw State University. Business.
You're funny.
MBA program number 4 in the South. Classes offered.
Look at you, Daisy.
Cobb Galleria and in Dalton. Competitive, convenient, connected. Registration at ksumba.com.
This is All Things Considered from NPR News. I'm Melissa Block, and I'm Lottie Cornish. The federal government has been at least partially shut down for 18 hours now. There are barricades in front of national monuments, and hundreds of employees are facing furlough and uncertainty about when.
Joey, you're tearing that up.
And on Capitol Hill, there seems to be no clear end to the shutdown. NPR congressional correspondent Tamara Keith joins us now from the Capitol. And Tamara, here we are again.
Again.
Walk us the heck up in terms of what happened last night. How did Congress get to the point of letting the shutdown happen?
At about 10:30 last night, House Republicans announced a plan to create a conference committee to negotiate out the differences between the House and the Senate. But a conference committee, those things take days. feared much earlier in the day. In fact, a shutdown became inevitable. This morning, the Senate came in and voted to not even take up that House offer.
Show your best side, Daisy.
Where we were days ago, there's a clean CR on the table. That is a bill to keep the government open through November 15th with no policy riders, none of the Obamacare delays or defunding that House Republicans have been demanding.
And this is the same bill that the Senate sent over on Friday and has been sent yesterday. So what's next with the ball? Is it back in the House's court?
It is, and yes, that was the exact same bill. Now the House is actually working on three bills. They're debating them now that would fund temporarily small parts of the government, popular parts of the government.
Hi, sweetie.
Veterans Administration,
are you having
the
fun?
DC government, and the Parks Department. Mike Simpson is an Idaho Republican and spoke in favor of the Parks.
What we need to do is put all the national parks, the Smithsonian, the Holocaust Museum, and others hostage to your desire to shut down the government. That's what's going on here. You think we're holding the Affordable Health Care Act hostage? You're holding our national parks hostage.
A number of members came up to the floor and talked about a group of World War II veterans who reportedly showed up at the World War II Memorial today here in Washington and had to push past barricades to get in to visit their memorial.
Now, these are bills to fund a piece of the government. They almost seem designed to be bills that no one could refuse. Will anyone vote against them?
I'm not sure how many people will vote against them because the votes haven't happened yet, but a number of Democrats speaking on the House floor said that they would vote no, that it's not fair to only fund
Daisy.
Popular parts of the government. They say, what about the National Institutes of Health doing cancer research or, doing or any other number of vital parts of the government?
What do you think, Joey?
The president said that a few things
you like that.
You veto them, the House minority.
You're liking that, aren't you?
And Senate Majority Leader Harry Reid said on the Senate floor that the best way to fund these popular programs is to fund the whole government.
This is not serious. The government shut down. And if they think they're going to come and nitpick us on this, it won't work. It won't work.
A spokesman for House Speaker John Boehner has responded now. He described the White House position as, quote, unsustainably hypocritical, especially since the president signed a bill yesterday to ensure that the troops continue to get paid during the shutdown.
So, Pamela, what's the endgame here? Senate Democrats won't budge on clean seal.
You know, at some point, someone is going to have to blink. Someone is going to have to budge. But right now, House and Senate, Democrats and Republicans, are in the finger-pointing blame game phase of this thing. And part of what happens may just depend on how loud the cries are from the public and the business community and furloughed federal employees.
That's NPR's Tamara Keith. Tamara, thank you.
You're welcome.
This week's government shutdown could be just a warm-up for
Daisy.
In a couple of weeks.
Don't you even think about it. Hi, sweetie, I love you. Yes, I do, I love you. Hi. How's my girl? Give me a kiss.
Shutdowns are messy and disruptive, but we've lived through them before. The U.S. government, on the other hand, has never had to go cold turkey.